Hi, hi. Now we are on our way up to the North Sea. It's a long time since I've been up there. I have thought about it in a long time. Now you have to go up there, but now I'm on my way. I could take the main road up there. I think we go to Tyborøn, fishing harbor up there. I could take the main road and just go up there, but I will use the day here to that trip here, and I take the small roads and just enjoy the trip up there. So I hope I can find something interesting to show you. Tyborøn is a pretty big fishing harbor. So let's see what there's there. I have worked on the Vice, and it's going the right way. I think this video here will only be with this trip here. I hope I could find enough to make a video of it. So let's see what I can find, and I hope I can find something interesting too. So let's see. Now we are on our way up to the North Sea. I found a high spot here, and you can see really, really long way out there in the horizon. That is the North Sea, and you can take a look around it here. We'll go up and take a closer look at it. Oh, you can see let's go over here and go. I'll zoom a little in here. There you can see there, that is, see, have I it right? Yes, that is the fjord. That is where the fjord I sail in starts here up at the North Sea. So there is a narrow sound there up with Tyborøn, where the fjord starting. That we'll go up and take a look at. Here is the fjord. In there, longer in, that is where I sail. Let's take a look at the map. Here is a map over Denmark, at Jylland, Fyn og Sjælland. Let's try to go a little closer, so see if I can explain it to you. Let's see there. You can see here is where we are, out here. And the water in here and out here, that is Limfjorden. Fur is there. Here, just in here, that was where I was lying last time I was out sailing. But what I see, if I can explain, you can see all of, here is the North Sea. You see all stands Westerhavet out there. And when under a storm, the water is going to be pressed down in the North Sea, then all the water has to come in here, where we are, and to fill up all the water here. It had to come in here. It can also come out here, but before it getting out here, there's also narrow out here. Then it there will be high tide, or high flood, I think I could call it. But it's here all the water is coming in. So you can see if the water raise out here maybe a meter and two, and then it have to come in here, then there will be a really current here. So You can see here I have sailed down here out here I've made some videos of last time also, and Livø I also have a video of, but it's here we are. So let's take a look out of it here. Maybe we should have a little more look. You can see here is Denmark, and it is here the water is running in, and you can see that that's west and northwest. If there's a storm from northwest or west up here that press water in here into the North Sea, then it will come and down here. I think I'm not sure, but I think there are also a lot of current down in the English Channel. Maybe some of you know that, but that is where when the water comes down here, and it only way it have to go is out there and around here and then into Limfjorden. But here is maybe a little easier to see why the water is coming down from here. Also, if it's just from the west, also southwest, the water will be pressed over against Denmark here. So, but let's take a look out on this the sound. Yes, as you can see, it's real narrow here, where all the water is coming in to Limfjorden. I think from when it's lowest and when it's highest, it's about 3 meter, and all that water have to come in here, and there can be really heavy heavy current out here, maybe so much as my boat can sail. But in a right day I could sail out here. I've always dreamt about it and try to go out on the North Sea. But here you can see, I hope there are coming a fishing vessel out. You can always there, it's not even out yet. You see the waves, they are bigger and there where I sail. I'll take a little clip at it when it get a little longer out. But let's go over here again and look up at you can see there's a pier out there, so it's not even really the North Sea yet there, but the North Sea can be tough. I think I have seen maps over old wrecks lying all along the coast. I think it were all thousands of wrecks lying out here, so it can be really tough. Oh, now here, just try to see this here. I'll just go over here. And it's not even out yet. Duncan, you maybe know this here. I think after what we have talked about. But, yes, let's just look at this one here a little. As you can see, if my little boat should go out there, I think I could sail out there, but it shall be a day when it's there's a seagull, where it's nice weather, really nice. It's a little windy today, but nothing in what can be here. I'll hold a little pause here and then we'll take a look at him a little later. Now they're coming one in also. Tyborn here is it's an active fishing harbor. It's bigger, this one there. Maybe it's not even a fishing boat, I'm not sure. There are also some links out to the offshores out here. I have seen
it could be some of this. It could be a boat to something out on the offshores. I think we are just lucky to see that one here up close coming in there. Maybe let's see what's the name of it. Cable One. Oh, I know it. I know. It's a diving company. I have it. They make from the local television here. They have searched down in wrecks out here. I have heard about that ship. That was fun to see. That was really, really great. I thought it looked a little different, but it was that one. So. They have been searching for. There's an old King and George, St. George, I think, an old wooden ship that went down here in for many years ago, and they have found many things for it. There's a museum over here from where all the things they have found on it. That was that ship. That was real fun. We caught that. But they're coming one more, so should we take that one also? Here's the next one that's coming in. There are boats coming in and out here all the time. I have not been here more than a half an hour. So it's a really active harbor up here. And you can see that one is loaded with fish. I think it may be. I think that is, I don't know, is it a trawler? It could look like it, but we can see it when it's getting closer. I think I can see the shovels on the side to the trawl, but I'm not 100% sure. Again, Duncan, you probably know what it is for a ship. You can even see that big ship there is rolling in with the waves, and it is almost in here in the harbor. It takes some skills to sail that. I don't think I would want to do it. I think it is a trawler. Oh, yeah, you can see. See if I can point just right there. That's the shovels. Nah, I'm not sure. I'm not sure. And here it's not a little Indian. It's a little. Oh yeah, you can see the blue things up on the back there. That is a trawler. This here. As you can also see the trawling net. Let's go closer. See if I can catch it there. The rolls there. There where the nets are, the trawl is hanging. That was fun to catch a few here, but let's take a look at the harbor also. Let's take a look here around the harbor. Can't see all of it, but I think I have found a spot where you can see most of it. It's fun. You can always hear the seagulls here up. Almost no matter where you are, you can hear the seagulls. And you can see up there, there are some smaller fishing boats. And you can see the masts back in far in the distance. That is where the pleasure boats are lying. That's not a big harbor up here, because will not come many sailing in here. It's not so many take a night over when they come in from the sea, and then they take a night over in here before they go into the fjord. That is some of the old houses from here up in Tuborg that was here. I think they are modernized very much, but they look the same on the outside. And up here you can see the pleasure boats. There's just come a Swedish boat in there. I think I can see a Norwegian flag also, and they are different. There's much more here than there is in my home harbor. So, but let's go out and take a look at the sea.
I'll just let the camera roll here down on the streets here in Tuborg. Try to notice there are no trees here, and almost no flowers or anything in front of the houses and gardens and things, because it can't grow here because of the salt that coming in from the sea. So there are some small trees that is almost blown apart. You can see over there, there's a little. So let's just see if we can go up here. The camera is tilting. Yeah, but there's a little vegetation, but nothing, not much. I don't know where I got now, but let's just take it up here. To try to see, I hope you can see that tree standing up against that house there. You can see that what's over the house, there is no more. It is going to be blown to pieces. So hope you could see that. But that's how the town here in Tuborg is looking. There are not so many tourists up here, but they come. There are many tourists here up at the North Sea here in the summertime. But that was just a clip from the town here.
Here is just a little clip more about the vegetation up here. You can see there's nothing over that fence there. That is blown away. And you can see when the wind comes out here from the sea, you can see it takes everything. Some small leaves are over the fence, but everything is blown away. Here you can see it. Everything is pointing east here, up with the sea. No, with the North Sea. Now we are at the sea, North Sea, or Vesterhavet, as we say. We call it both. Yes, it maybe sounds a little fun, but the West Sea, if I say it in Danish, but it's called the North Sea, but it's the western part of Denmark, so we call it the both North Sea and West Sea, Vesterhavet. So, but you can take a look at it here. I'll also go down and we'll film just out in the waves there. It's really fresh up here. The wind and everything. I think it's healthy to be here. So it's bigger, much bigger than I usually sail in, and that I talked about to sail out there, as it'd be much less wind than is now. But I've not guessed that there are more than 10 meter per second. But just to sit here and watch the waves, I enjoy that. I really do. So go a little up here. A little funny thing. That radar I have on my boat, when I got it, I found there's a place up here where you can drive in with your car, and you can see out off this over the sea here. And I took the radar, and it runs on 12 volt, and then put the antenna up on my roof of my car. And then I sat in my car and looked at the screen. I could see the ships out there. It go up to 16 nautical miles, so up to that I never can do in the fjord. But it worked up here. That was a little funny. But here's a little clip from the North Sea. We'll go down here to where the waves break now. Now we are all down with the sea. You can see the beach there. There are not many days here in Denmark where you can. It's not warm down here today. It's not cold, but not that you can lie in the sun or anything like that. It's too cold. And the water, yes, it can, but I have tried to go in it, but it is cold. But I came to sit and think of, I have also looked it up on the map. John Mills from Double Boost, he's living right over on the other side here. So that's a really funny thing to think about. But let's just enjoy the sea here for a little while.